the 12-horsepower motor the Wright brothers used to fly the first powered airplane in 1903 fulfilled man's dream of flying through the air, and the propeller design was later incorporated in 1908 for a contract with the U.S. Army for a Wright brother plane which could fly at speeds of 64 miles per hour for 10 minutes. But it's a far cry from modern 500 mile per hour propeller planes with 1200 or more mile ranges. So how have such planes evolved? The principles are still similar. Spinning propeller blades are angled to slice through the air in a way where air takes a longer path at the front, decreasing air pressure in the accelerated air and forcing air from the back to sweep in to balance the pressure difference, also known as the Bernoulli principle. The propellers are also twisted, as the end of the twist near the center increases air resistance, balancing out the greater force exerted on the faster moving outside of the propeller, which is angled to slice through the air without additional resistance. The wings of the plane work in a similar way, being curved out towards the top and flat at the bottom to decrease pressure above and therefore generate lift from below. And modern propeller engines are also similar to those used in the past, using a design comparable to a car engine with pistons and revolutions. Only many propeller plane engines are air-cooled. However, major differences lead to the totally different performances. While propeller planes in the past were made of wood, aluminum alloy and hollow steel are used today, and such differences in materials have, of course, made their way into lighter, stronger frames with increased aerodynamics. Not to mention, the improvements in engine designs allow for a far more powerful, compact, and lighter engine as well. Because propeller planes are more fuel efficient and have longer endurance than jet turbine planes, some commercial airliners used today are propeller planes, and propeller design has even made its way into such purposes as the Italian and Russian air forces, though the ride is not as smooth as jet turbines unless noise dampening technology is used. Jet turbines, in contrast, are less fuel efficient but much faster, working through sucking air into a turbine before igniting and blasting huge amounts of fuel through the back end of the turbine. This propulsion, used in jets and many commercial airliners, is totally different from propeller-driven planes, as it works the same way a flying balloon does. But so-called turbopropeller planes also exist, working the same way jet turbines do, but using a propeller to direct the air into the rear instead. Other interesting designs which have propped up in propeller airplanes include using multiple propellers or two sandwiched propellers spinning in opposite directions to improve liftoff for large warplanes, and from World War II memorabilia to hobby use to commercial or military aircraft, propeller airplanes won't go out of style anytime soon.